Welcome to the Best Coast Shire Council Report, your weekly update on council news and events.
Hi, I'm Lauren Grills.
And I'm Steve Fury.
Welcome to this week's show, where we'll be talking about some new laws for cat owners, the Best Coast Business Awards. But first, Steve, have you ever wanted to be a councillor?
Personally, no. But there may be members of the community who are thinking about it. Much of the public's attention at the moment is focused on the federal election, but we'd like to steer the spotlight a little more our way. We're encouraging community-minded citizens to consider standing for council on October the 22nd.
Becoming a councillor is a great way to influence the future direction of your local community. If you're over 18 and on the electoral roll for the council area, then chances are you're eligible to stand for council.
Now, when you think about it, communities are made up of a really diverse mix of people, so we want to encourage people from all walks of life to nominate as a candidate. It doesn't matter what your occupation or your cultural background or your gender is, or whether you're retired, a stay-at-home parent or a university student, everyone's welcome to join the election race.
Deciding to stand for council is a big decision. A councillor's role is exciting but also fairly demanding, and prospective candidates should find out what's involved before nominating for election. A number of information sessions will be run in August.
That's right, Lauren. The first session's going to be run on Monday the 22nd of August at the Grantfield Transaction Centre, then Tuesday the 23rd at the Cowes Cultural Centre, and the last session is in the Civic Centre Council Chamber in Wonthaggi on Thursday the 25th of August. Now, all these sessions will run from 7 to 9pm, and if you need more information, just contact us on the numbers on the end of the show, or visit the campaign website standforcouncil.com.au.
Steve, soon we'll be starting a public education program, two new laws that will affect cat owners. Next year, on April the 10th, the state government will change the Domestic Animals Act of 1994 that will require mandatory de-sexing of newly registered cats from the age of 3 months. There will also be a nighttime containment order from sunset to sunrise.
Now, there's some good reasoning behind these changes. According to the Australian Wildlife Conservatory, around 20 million feral cats in Australia kill up to 4 animals a night. Now, the aim is to reduce these attacks and also unwanted litters of kittens. There's also a parasitic disease called toxoplasmosis, which is quite nasty, believe me, I've looked it up and you don't want it. Reducing the number of feral cats will help control this and also the spread of feline HIV, which can affect your pet cat at home.
We receive around 150 requests a year from people wanting to borrow one of council's free cat traps to deal with a nuisance cat on their property. We also get around 80 complaints about cats at large, which shows that stray cats are a problem. Over the years, we've worked closely with Phillip Island Nature Parks and Parks Victoria on the problem of feral cats, and hopefully these new laws will really help rein in their numbers.
Yeah, and hopefully help our native species as well. The 2016 Bass Coast Business Awards are now open. And if you're a business owner, these awards will not only help recognise the hard work of your staff, but give your customers a chance to give you some accolades as well.
Nearly 8,000 registered small businesses in Bass Coast can throw their hat into the ring for these awards. There are six categories, which includes business excellence, marketing and promotion, new business, environment and sustainability, and good access.
One of these businesses will also be named the 2016 Bass Coast Business of the Year, which would be a good way to raise the profile of your business. Entries are open until the 11th of July, so head on over to basscoast.vic.gov.au/business awards to find out more.
If your business is registered to receive business mail with Australia Post, you'll have a business awards kit posted to you. The kit includes information for entrants and a promotional poster to display in your business for the People's Choice Awards to encourage your customers to vote.
With the People's Choice Award, we're asking members of the community to vote for any business running in Bass Coast they believe provides exceptional service. And by doing so, you might win yourself a $250 shopping voucher. Entries are limited to one per person per business, and nominations close at 5pm on Monday the 11th of July.
The excitement of the Business Awards culminates at the awards presentation dinner on Friday the 19th of August at Silverwater Resort in San Remo. This evening is open to all businesses, not just those who have entered, and any business can book a table for their staff and friends.
Last year's event was very popular, so book early to avoid missing out. You can contact Council's Business Development Officer Emily Barkley for a booking on the numbers at the end of the show, or email emily.barkley, that's emily.barkley@bascoast.vic.gov.au. You can also book on and pay online at 2016 Bass Coast Business Awards.eventbrite.com.au.
And that's all we've got time for this week. As always, if you have any questions or need more information about anything we've mentioned, give us a call on 1300 BCOAST. That's 1300 226 278 or 03 5671 2211. And keep up to date on our Facebook page at facebook.com/Bass Coast Shire, or follow us on Twitter on @Bass Coast. Catch you next week for more council news.
The Vasco Shire Council Report is broadcast on Tuesday mornings at 9:30, Thursday afternoons at 4:30, and on Saturday mornings at 10 on your community station 3MFM. Audio and transcript is also available from our website, vascoast.vic.gov.au.